I mean, this Saab Viggen ticks every single Saab box. Thing is, it's quite funny because Mike loves a Saab too. So inadvertently, he's actually agreed to tackle some of the big jobs for me. So Mike's going to do the spoiler. He's going to do the interior. He's also going to do the mirrors, the bonnet and the bumper. Basically, the bits of the car that you can see, leaving me to tackle the bits of the car you can't see. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a pile of Mike bits. And then I'm going to turn my attention to my bits. And all these bits come off by simply removing a few screws and the electrical plugs. Now, Mike is confident he can find a bumper, and to be fair, he's never let me down. Yeah, the clear coat's been really affected. But the paint underneath looks good. I reckon this can be saved. Oh, I love this interior. It just looks and feels expensive, although not at the moment. See, back in the day, this car was billed as a competitor to the BMW M3, which I know is a matter of opinion. But in my experience, Saab owners don't care about opinions. They're the type of people that are comfortable in their own skin. But that's Saab all over, you know, kind of super cool, doing their own thing. So this is Mike's pile. Now, the biggest issue on this car is the coolant leak. You see, no one wants to buy a car with a potential head gasket issue, except Mike, who seems to make a habit of it. Now, to help me diagnose the leak, I have this kit. Now, this piece here replaces the cap on the expansion tank, and just like the cap, it's airtight, apart from this little outlet. Then in the kit, there's this pump that clips directly on that outlet. And then with the hand pump, I can actually increase the pressure within the sealed system to simulate as if the engine was running. Now, having that pressurized system is really good for the car, because everybody knows water boils at 100 degrees centigrade. But what you may not know is that only applies at sea level. If the pressure's lower, the boiling point's lower, and in reverse, if the pressure's higher, the boiling point's higher. So having a sealed system in a car means the engine can run hotter. And if it can run hotter, it's better for fuel efficiency. Right, 16 psi, don't go beyond that. And now the system's under pressure, I can start having a closer look. It's now quite obvious where it's coming from. The corner of that head gasket, right there. Right, well, I'm gonna have to start stripping the engine down a bit. This Saab, the head bolts are actually hidden underneath the valve cover. So if I take it off, like so, there they are. So those bolts are responsible for bolting the head, the top section of the engine, to the block, the bottom section, with a gasket in the middle to take up any tolerance. And it's right at the gasket on that front corner there, well, that's where our leak is. See, now that the engine's all open, I get a better look at what's going on. And yeah, the leak is definitely coming from between the block, the darker metal, and the head, the aluminium. Now, before I go any further, there is actually a curious anomaly with this particular engine, especially on that front corner. So I just want to check. That's the one. By placing this on that head bolt that's on the corner. There we go. Look at that. See, the head bolt, bear in mind it's a head bolt, is finger tight. It's really, really loose. Now, this engine, the 9.3, is exactly the same as the 9.5. And up to a certain year, which happens to be 2001, the year of our car, this engine had a problem. And that's because Saab, on the factory floor, fitted those head bolts with an anti-friction paste and some wax. And because of that, they have a tendency to work loose. These new bolts here are called torque to yield, or TTY for short. They're actually designed to stretch. So I plan to swap out the Saab hard bolts for the nice new stretchy ones. Right, that is as far as I'm going to go because, of course, I need to follow the Saab manual, which tells me that these bolts need to be torqued down. Now, the first pass is going to be at 30 foot-pounds, right there. And a second pass at 44. And that's one bolt. I need to repeat that sequence for all of them. Now, it's absolutely essential that you follow the correct Saab pattern. The point of it is to spread the load. If I was to just undo them all, the head would pop off and the gasket would be toast. Now, if this works, this is going to be good news for me because it stands a fair chance of solving our coolant leak just by tightening some bolts. Right, this is the last one, the problem corner. Now, I have been crossing my fingers and holding my breath because ultimately I can't see the gasket. And what happens, if the leak's been going on for some time, it would have worn a channel away in the gasket and it would be ruined anyway. At the moment, those are only finger tight because there is a torquing sequence for the valve cover. Now, it's only 11 foot-pounds, but the sequence is essential. I'm just going to run the car, get it up to temperature. So what I'm doing is I'm keeping half an eye on the temperature gauge. I want the water temperature to rise. I want the engine to operate under changing temperatures. I want the metal within the block and the head to expand and contract. And if after that it still leaks, then unfortunately it's a head gasket. Now, this has been a bit of a roller coaster. See, on the face of it, it looked like a head gasket issue, and in any other make or model, it probably would have been. But it turns out it's a Saab issue, or more specifically, a Saab 9.5 engine issue, which actually transpired to be quite an easy fix, which is great news for me, and better news for Mike's wallet. Now, there is something under the car, which I think Mike may have missed, and it's this little drop of oil here. Now, fluid in this portion of the car leads me to one thing. The convertible roof on a Saab Viggen is hydraulic, and of course, hydraulics need fluid. Now, hydraulic systems are really, really good. That is, of course, if all the fluid stays in the right place. Now, actually, when you break it down, the components to a hydraulic system are relatively simple. And that normally means, and obviously I'm saying this with a pinch of salt, that the fix itself can be relatively simple as well. Now, the ram I want to access is buried right in there. Now, a ram, in very simple terms, is basically a cylinder with a plunger in it, kind of like a medical syringe, only the rams on the Saab are built to withstand huge amounts of pressure, enough to raise and lower the roof. Now, because a ram's made up of moving parts, it needs rubber seals to help keep the fluid inside, and over time they wear out. And that's obvious what's happened here, because the rams are leaking quite badly.
Ha-ha! Nice! Svenka Poiken Askasab.
What?
Svenka Poiken Askasab. It's a little bit of Swedish, isn't it? My friend loves Saabs.
What are you on about?
Well, I want to get a bit of lingo in because I've got a great idea where we're going to take the car for a drive at the end.
Sweden?
No, we're not going
to... Let's take it to Stockholm.
No, we're not going to Stockholm.
No, no, we can put the car on a ferry, we can get on a plane, fly there nice first class of course.
No, we're not doing that. Just leave it to me. I've got a really good idea. These are the suspension mounts you were after.
Thank you.
So, I'm a little bit surprised you didn't ask me for a head gasket.
No, I managed to fix the head gasket without needing a head gasket. Tie them up, torque them down.
That's all it was. They were just loose.
That was it. And I'm right in the middle. In fact, check this out.
Ooh, leaking. Yeah, that's a really bad problem, actually, because there's only a couple of companies in the world that actually make the rams, and then there's only a couple of companies in the world that will have an attempt at refurbishing them. I know one company that can do it. How quickly can you get them off?
20 minutes.
All right, well, let me make a call and see if I can get them sorted, and you get them off.
OK.
Click here to subscribe.